Hey YouTube, Common Collector here, and today I am bringing you an update to my Evil Eye deck profile, or in other words, just a different variant of it. So back in July, I did a deck profile on Evil Eyes paired with Artifacts, and ever since the 2020 Megatins came out and these cards got a lot cheaper, everyone sort of swarmed and started watching that, so I think that video is like above 5,000 views, which was crazy because it was only at a couple hundred right away when it came out. So you guys really seem to be into Evil Eye right now. So I wanted to bring you guys this more pure variant. If you guys do want to check out that other deck profile just to see how you can run it with Artifacts to run more of a Floodgate style, go for that. Otherwise, this is going to be a more pure variant, which just sort of deals with running a little bit more regular hand traps as well as other disruptions and then focusing on getting out the Evil Eye cards. Also, I did a video on the lore of the Evil Eye, so if you guys want to go check that out, go ahead and look at that. Also, a link to that will be in the description down below. Just sort of going over the mythology of all of these really cool cards. I've always really loved this archetype. It's really powerful. Maybe not as powerful as other control decks like Altergeist and whatnot, and it can't really do a full grind out like Altergeist can, but this deck can grind as well as like can just sort of close out a game in one turn, so it's sort of like a really explosive control deck, which is really cool. So we obviously have three copies of Surzeal. He is your best starter of the deck. He searches out an Evil Eye card on summon, and as long as he is equipped with your Evil Eye of Selene, he's going to destroy one of your opponent's special summon monsters as a quick effect, which is really, really nice. Then also you guys should take note that during the next standby phase, after you activate his effect, you have to destroy one card that you control, which is not a big deal because we actually have a handful of cards in our deck that we enjoy destroying. That is a really nice part of running the artifact engine with this deck, but I decided to kick it out just for this variant. Besides that, we were playing two copies of Basilisk, which I really like playing the two. In my opinion, you have to be playing two of this card because you almost always want to see it on your opening hand, but if you don't, it's not a big deal. You can usually search for it. But yeah, seeing it on your opening hand is super nice. Basically, these two cards in your opening hand, it's just super easy to go into your simple link plays. Then we have Medusa, Watcher of the Evil Eye. She's really great late game, so I like playing just one copy of her. I still wouldn't want to totally drop her out of the deck, but basically with her, she picks up one Evil Eye card from your graveyard when she's summoned, so it's really nice if you have your equip spell, the Evil Eye of Gorgoneo, sitting in your graveyard. You just summon this onto the field, and then you, as long as your opponent has more life points than you, then you can sometimes just push for game right there, and your Basilisk, Familiar of the Evil Eye, is going to help set up your graveyard really well. Then for our final Evil Eye monster, we're playing just one copy of the Cataplast. You could bump this up to two if you really wanted to, but I still like it at one. So this is your best card for going into big link plays, like trying to go into your link three. Because after you use this as link material, you can then just use its effect to special summon itself back to the field as long as you have an Evil Eye card on the field. And then also he gives a little bit of protection to a Evil Eye spell or trap, so that's like kind of nice. It comes up, you know, like, you know, if you have him on the field, then it's really nice to use that effect. You know, there's no reason not to. Then a new addition to the deck, which I've really been liking now, is three copies of Tour Guide from the Underworld. So the main reason why I dropped the artifact engine is because if you're running the artifacts, it's kind of hard to make room for the Tour Guide and then have all of the rest of the classic cards that you want for this control style. So I kind of liked adding the Tour Guides and getting away from the Floodgates and just focusing on more of the pure Evil Eye control. But with this card, you special summon a level 3 or lower Fiend, and so you can get either your Basilisk or your Cataplast, which is really, really nice. So that's kind of why you could play two copies of the Cataplast, but there are other options with this deck. If you, like, you know, say you've used up all of your Evil Eye cards, you can really just pick up another Tour Guide and that'll work just as well. Then we're going to go on into, obviously, three copies of Ash Blossom. This is a control deck, so you just want to make sure that you're controlling your opponent's crucial plays, and this is just sort of the simplest way to do that. Then we're going to go on into, for our spells, three copies of Evil Eye Domain Pareidolia. This card is just super good. It sort of does everything that you really need a field spell to do. So basically what this does is it searches your Evil Eye cards, your Evil Eye monster, I should say. And then if you have your Evil Eye of Selene and you get hit by one of your opponent's monsters for the first battle, you can make your opponent take the damage with you. I've actually won games because my opponent doesn't notice that, and then they'll just bash into you if you have a low attack monster, and then then they'll just take the damage with you. And then besides that, if this card gets destroyed, then you can get an Evil Eye monster back to your hand, which is really nice. It doesn't come up that often, but this is a great target to destroy for your Surzeal, because he has to destroy a card during standby phase, which is pretty cool. Then we're going on into two copies of our Evil Eye of Selene, which is like, it is the center point of the deck, obviously, because a lot of the cards that I've mentioned so far, if you have the equip spell, then they gain all these bonus effects. But with this card, when it's equipped to your Evil Eye monster, it can't be destroyed by battle or by card effects, and then your opponent can't target it with card effects, which is super duper nice. Then besides that, every time you activate that monster, the equipped monster's effect, or any other Evil Eye spell or trap card, then you pay 500 life points and then juice up your monster by 500, and that attack boost stays even if Selene leaves, which is really, really nice. And then also besides that, if this card is chilling in the graveyard, then you can set it to your side of the field by banishing another Evil Eye spell or trap, and then paying 1,000 life points, which is really nice, just that it keeps recurring. Then we're going on into actually my favorite equip spell of the deck, which is Gorgoneo, because Gorgoneo can just win you games. So basically, if your life points are lower than your opponent's, then this card juices up your attack of your monsters by that difference in the attack points. So like I said, this card is really nice with your Medusa. If you're late game and you're about to lose, then you just normal summon Medusa. You're going to get your Gorgoneo from the graveyard back to your hand, which is super duper nice. Besides that, with this, if you discard an Evil Eye card, you can add an Evil Eye spell or trap from your deck to your graveyard just by banishing this from the graveyard. You add an Evil Eye spell or trap from your deck to your hand while this is in your graveyard. I'm not sure if I said that right the first time, but super nice. All you got to do is discard an Evil Eye card to get that effect off. Then we have one Evil Eye Remergence. I dropped this down to one. I had it originally at two and maybe even three way back when it first came out, but I kind of like it just at one if you need it. But with the tour guides in the deck, you really don't need to be running more than one Remergence. You're really just running it because it's an Evil Eye name. But this card gives you a token. If you have Gorgoneo or Evil Eye of Selene on the field, then this is going to give you two tokens. I also forgot to mention that Evil Eye Gorgoneo is treated as Evil Eye of Selene while it's on the field. That's actually pretty important. So besides that, Remergence is nice. You can banish it from the graveyard, and then all of your Evil Eye spell and traps are safe for the turn. But overall, this card is pretty, it's decent, but I still like it just as at one. That way you can use it as an Evil Eye name if you need to discard or banish or whatever. But I wanted to add one Called by the Grave into the deck just because we do really need those searches like Pareidolia and Surzeal to go off. So that's why I made that decision to cut the extra copy. So we have one Evil Eye Awakening, one Confrontation just to destroy spells and traps. I have a pretty strict rule that you have to have at least one form of spell or trap removal that is a spell or trap, because of Mystic Mind. Basically, it gives me trust issues, so that's why I like one Confrontation. Plus, it's searchable, so that's really nice. One copy of Evil Eye Repose. Again, it's another Evil Eye name. And then also, this is just actually really nice for this current meta. Helps you to get around stuff that can't be destroyed by battle or card effects and whatnot. So with this card, it is basically an upstart goblin when you activate it, and then it is a continuous spell. So then besides that, when this card's on the field and you have your equip spell on the field on a monster, when that monster attacks an opponent's monster, then you just banish it. So that's just super nice for getting rid of stuff like Red-Eyes Dark Dragoon and just other stuff. I know that I'm kind of sounding like a broken record in all my deck profiles saying that this is how you get around Red-Eyes Dark Dragoon or Numeron and stuff, but I just think that that's important to keep in mind this format. Three Pot of Extravagance. This is a little bit cheaper nowadays because of the reprints from the Megatins, but if you guys can't afford it, it's really not that big of a deal. You can actually play Upstart Goblin in here, and Upstart Goblin is really fun because of your Evil Eye of Gorgoneo, because it juices up your opponent's life points by 1,000, and you draw a card, and then as long as you have Gorgoneo, that increase doesn't even matter. Then you have one copy of Called by the Grave and one copy of Terraforming just to search out your field spell. But again, I've already mentioned the Called by the Grave is just super important for making sure that you get those searches off, because people said when Called by the Grave got hit on the ban list that it was a hit on combo decks, but I really think that it was a hit on control, because combo decks can play through. That's why they're combo decks, but Called by the Grave is pretty essential for decks like this, where you have those really crucial searches, and if you don't get them off, like especially in this, if you don't get that Surzeal off to add your Pareidolia or your Evil Eye of Selene, then your plays are pretty much screwed from there. And then you have to rely on all of your traps. But speaking of which, we're going to go on into the traps. We have three copies of Infinite Impermanence. Again, if you can't afford this, you can go into three copies of Effect Veiler, or you can even just slim down on the Impermanence and the Effect Veilers and go with like artifacts or really just whatever you want. Again, you can use Upstart Goblin, really anything you want. And even also besides Upstart, you can play Pot of Duality. I've seen some people play that. I like the option to special summon, so I don't like playing Duality. Then we have three copies of Crackdown. I'm really happy to see this back because I took it out for the artifact variant. But for this version, Crackdown is really, really nice just to steal an opponent's card. Then we're going on, again, another card that I'm happy to see back. I believe I took out Judgment from my other deck profile, but two copies of Judgment in here is really nice. Again, it kind of synergizes with the Gorgoneo because you kind of want your life points to get a little bit lower with this deck. And so with the Solemn Judgment, that's just going to help to cut your life points in half. And then you can just pound in with the Gorgoneo. And with Judgment, it's just super nice to make sure that you can negate stuff like, big things like Lightning Storm. Harpy's Feather Duster is in the format now, so you got to keep that in mind. Twin Twisters, Cosmic Cyclone, whatever's going to bust up your board and get rid of your Evil Eye of Selene. Evenly matches another big one that really hurts this deck, so that's why I really like the two Judgment. And then also two copies of Evil Eye Retribution for the same reason. It's searchable, but you want to play two copies so that you always see either a Solemn Judgment or a Retribution. Then for our 40th card, we're playing one copy of Evil Eye of Defeat. This card is a compulse, but if you have your equip spell, it is a double compulse, which is super duper nice. So that's going to round it off for the 40 card Evil Eye deck. I hope you guys like my sleeves. Let's get on into the extra deck. So for the extra deck, we are playing, of course, three copies of our Gorgon Empress of the Evil-Eyed. We're playing Extravagance, so we want to be playing three copies of everything. When I pulled this Starlight Rare, I gotta tell you, I fell in love with the Evil-Eyed deck. That was why I built it, because I pulled this and I thought, wow, this deck seems really awesome, and it really is. When I pulled this, I knew that I wanted to build the deck, and after I built it, it like very rapidly became one of my favorites just because I love the style. Everyone loves like that whole Gren Mazu OTK style kind of a deck, and a lot of people like playing control, and this is just a beautiful blend of the two. But basically what Gorgon does is that it gains 100 attack for every different Evil Eye card in your graveyard, which is pretty nice. You can get two decent numbers with that alone, but then also when it's equipped with your equip spell, you can once per turn negate one monster that your opponent controls as a quick effect. So your Surzeal is going to destroy a monster. Gorgon negates, which is really nice. And then you have three copies of your Surzeal. Whenever he is Link summoned, he is your Link 3. When he's Link summoned with a monster with 2600 or more attack, he can attack twice per battle phase, which is really nice. Just to make sure that like this card can really close out games super duper fast. So you have your Empress, which is going to negate a monster effect, and then you have Surzeal, which can actually just quick effect destroy one card on the field, which is nice. So you have your Surzeal for monster removal, and then Surzeal just works for any kind of removal, which is really, really cool. Then besides that, you just have to keep in mind that they all have sort of like a quote-unquote negative effect during the next standby phase after their effect. So Surzeal destroys one card that you control. Gorgon, Empress of the Evil Eye, destroys one card that it points to, so it has up and down arrows. So you can actually kind of use that to your advantage if your opponent has something, you know, even something right up there. That's just sort of nice that you can use that option. And then Xurzeal is going to negate the effects of an effect monster that it points to. So that's sort of like the main six cards that you need in here, especially if you're playing Extravagance. Then the rest kind of comes up to player preference. I like one copy of IP Mask Arena because if you have the tour guide from the underworld and you're all out of Evil Eye monsters, then you can just do tour guide and tour guide, go into IP Mask Arena, and then maybe try to go for something else. But besides that, playing, you know, two copies of each of the nightmares just for a little bit of extra removal. Also, your Evil Eye... I got to think of the name right now, Evil Eye Remergence, your spell card. Yeah, Evil Eye Remergence, which generates your tokens, locks you into Fiends. So you got to keep that in mind that if you want to use that, you're going to be locked into Fiends anyways. So you might as well keep the Nightmare package. And then one copy of Unchained Abomination. Again, he's a Fiend. And then one copy of Mech Knight Crusadia Avramax. It's really, really easy to go into him with like your Gorgon. And then if your opponent has a link to, like, Anaconda that you want to steal with your Crackdown. So overall, that just works really, really nice. Now we'll go into some really quick side deck options. So if we're fighting up against a combo deck and our opponent is opting to go first, then we obviously want to be playing three copies of Nibiru, three evenly matched, and then you can also throw in three copies of Dark Ruler No More. These nine have worked really, really well for me in the past for this side deck, so I probably won't ever change that. Dark Ruler No More could be changed with Forbidden Droplet, but I don't think you really have the card advantage in this deck that you can really afford to do that, so that's why I like the Dark Ruler No More. Then we've got three copies of Triple Tactical Talents, just sort of a replacement again for Called by the Grave. So if your opponent's going first, your Solemn Judgments and stuff are kind of useless, so that's when you want to swap in things like Triple Tactical Talents or even a Mind Control. And then just for the last two cards, I play Cosmic Cyclone and Harpy's Feather Duster. I understand that in this side deck, that's where it's going to be getting a lot more expensive than how the main deck looks, but there is a lot of different options that you can do with the side deck. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this deck profile. This has been one of my favorite decks ever since I started playing it. So I'm going to get to editing this video, and I am definitely going to be just hopping on Dueling Nexus again and playing this all night because I just really love this deck. And yeah, picking it back up and editing this deck has been a lot of fun, got me really back in the mood to play Evil Eye. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the deck profile. Please hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and we'll catch you guys next time. Bye.